What's up, guys? It's your boy, The Baby Boom, and I am back for another video. In the most recent Boruto chapter, we got introduced to new Tintail characters, the new villains of Boruto, and one of the characters looked exactly like Sasuke. So, I'm officially calling this new version of Sasuke Tintail Sasuke. So, let's get into how strong this version of Tintail Sasuke is, because there's a lot to actually analyze from this one chapter just seeing him. It's a lot of interesting stuff, so let's get right into it. So first of all, let's start off with the battle with Boruto in this version of Tintail Sasuke. So Heavenly Village, Cole gets away from Boruto, sneaks away back to his dimension where he has the Tintails, right? Boruto gets there and Cole's surprised that he's there, and then you get these Tintail type villains that appear and they attack Cole. Boruto, and the first one Boruto ain't that scared about. I think this is the weakest version of the Tintails, the one with fur around his body's kind of small, and he has the weird looking face. He has a weird face, and he's like Cold's old companion. He looks just like him, so that one I think is the weakest. But then you get the other three. They appear and Boruto and Cold are both surprised. The one I think is the strongest, the one that was in the air flying, because he appears on Cold and Boruto and both of them are shocked that he's hovering above both of them. They're both shocked by it. And then you got the girl, she appears, and Cold and Boruto are shocked by that. And then you get the Tintail Sasuke that appears, and Boruto's shocked by it. He's shocked by it, and that already shows, like, man, these guys, their speed is on a whole different level. Like, they appeared, and Boruto's a pretty powerful guy. He could take on this version of Cold, and this version of Cold's like a Jigen or Ishiki level of powerful. So that means, like, speed wise, they already getting Boruto. They're already they already got Boruto tripping about that. So then Sasuke Tintails attacks Boruto. Boruto's dodging, and then Boruto does a Rasengan. This version of Tintail Sasuke does a Chidori, and it cancels out with each other. And before Boruto can do any more moves, another Tintails character tries to attack Boruto, and that's the end of their confrontation. And I just love the confrontation, man. It's a small and simple confrontation, but you get a lot out of it. And yeah, from what we saw, they are equal. They're equal, and Boruto seems like he's not going full out. He's pretty calm in the situation. He does a really good job at staying calm. And this Tintails version of Sasuke also seems really calm, like he didn't really have to do anything. And Boruto dodges his moves. Tintail Sasuke doesn't get hurt. So at the moment, I would say that they were able to cancel each other out. But later on, I'll give you my opinions who I think would have won the fight. But let's get into Damon. Let's talk about Damon. Damon just destroyed Cold. He made Cold look like a goofy. So I think Damon versus him, versus this new version of the Tintails, would be a close fight. All these Tintails characters, these new villains, were making fun of Cold, making Cold seem like he was nothing. So I think they're all in the same range as Damon, and they just don't take Cold seriously. Boruto doesn't take Cold seriously. And I just love to see Damon go one-on-one with this Tintail Sasuke. I think it'll be a very entertaining fight. But let's talk about Naruto, man. Naruto, the former strongest character of Boruto. Earlier in Boruto, Naruto, you know, he was around Madara, Six Paths level, Sasuke level. They were all around that level still, the Six Paths Madara level, and they were never Kage level. They never could beat Kage, but they could steal her away. It's a big difference. Then you got their fight with Momoshiki. Together, they can beat Momoshiki, and I'm gonna say, I think separately, they can kind of take on Momoshiki too, because at moments, it's like they're not really taking him seriously. So maybe Momoshiki would beat them one-on-one, but they would hold their own for a good minute. But then you get to Jigen. Jigen just beats them up in his Jigen form by himself. He makes them look goofy and it's bad. Then he turns into Ishiki Osusuke and then it's even worse. He just starts dominating them. And then you get Bariyamo Naruto. Bariyamo Naruto is able to beat down Ishiki Otsutsuki. He's playing with him. And I believe this version of Ishiki is around Cold's level. So Bariyamo Naruto could probably beat Cold. He probably could beat Cold. But that's where it stops. These new villains, man, they are way above Cold. They're way above Cold, and I couldn't see Bariyamo Naruto hanging on against these new villains. Even against Ishiki, sometimes Ishiki did some stuff to get some damage on Bariyamo Naruto. So going against these villains with Sasuke's abilities, I couldn't see Naruto winning the fight. I'm sorry, but that's how I feel. So let's go into the flaws of this new version of Sasuke, Ten-Tail Sasuke. Boruto does not seem afraid of these guys. He does not seem afraid of these guys. And a big thing with Boruto, I think Boruto might actually be able to beat Ten-Tail Sasuke. I think Boruto might actually be able to beat all of these Ten-Tail characters. He just was using so much chakra in the Henley Village and he used the real powerful Rasengan, then he used the flying Gaijin, and then he was fighting them all at the same time, and he was still calm. So that makes the Ten Tails version of Sasuke look kind of bad. It's like, wow, Boruto was kind of playing, and if he had a team with him, or he had these villains one-on-one with just him, I think Boruto might be able to beat Ten Tails Sasuke. That's kind of, I know you probably shocked, like, whoa, okay, Boruto can still go with these guys, but the way he just was reacting to these guys, staying calm and never was afraid in that situation, it just seems like Boruto was gonna, he could beat them one-on-one, but he got jumped, so yeah, Boruto probably would have been able to win. And then Cold, he seemed like he's not really that afraid of him either, too, so that also was interesting. These new Ten Tails villains also, they seem like they kind of have a weakness. It seems like Cole can like take away their chakra or make them back to their original Ten Tails form. And I think that could play a part in them getting taken down. So I think there's just a lot of flaws with these, with the Ten Tail Sasuke characters. But next, we're about to get to comparing this version of Sasuke to all the other versions of Sasuke. Because I have an opinion. I think this is the strongest version of Sasuke throughout the whole show at the moment. And we thought Sasuke was never going to get another power-up throughout the show. So first of all, we'll start off with Kid Sasuke. Kid Sasuke is around at the most, let me think. The Curse Mark Kid Sasuke is around Kurama's like level one form of Ninetales, and that's not really powerful. I think Kakashi could even beat that version of Naruto, possibly. It's possible. So early Kakashi probably could take it on, and yeah, we know later on, like, Ten Tails versus the One Tail is just a sweep. Ten Tails wins, takes out that version of Curse Mark Sasuke. Then we got Hebi Sasuke or Orochimaru Sasuke. This version of Sasuke probably can take on, actually, he has a Sharingan, so he might be able to, he could control the Nine Tails as chakra sometimes. So that was a pretty cool scene. But his power level, he's less than Itachi. And he beat Deidara. So he's around Deidara level. And Deidara beat Gaara. So Gaara level. And yeah, I think the Momoshiki beat up Gaara. Even stronger version of Gaara. So yeah, I think Ten Tail Sasuke would just destroy him. Ten Tail Sasuke would take him out. Then you got Mangekyo, Five Kage Summon Sasuke. That one is around the same level as Rokage, Madara, without even having his Ten Tails form, beat the Rokage. So, Ten Tails, Sasuke just takes him out. Then, the last version of Sasuke in Naruto Shippuden couldn't even beat Ten Tails Madara, so Ten Tails Sasuke takes him out also. So, that's how I feel about it. Boruto Sasuke is the same way. Couldn't beat Madara, so I think Ten Tails Sasuke would take him out. Ten Tails Sasuke is pretty powerful, and he's around Damon, Boruto, new time skip Boruto level, and they're around Jigen, Momoshiki, Bayamo, Naruto level. They're all in that same area, and yeah, right now Ten Tails Sasuke is up there. He's one of the strongest characters. So tell me how y'all feel about this, and I'll see you on the next video. Anime Boom Out, peace.